Hello all, and welcome to the channel SIWRI, that is Spatial Information and Water Research Initiative. This YouTube channel is totally dedicated to water resource engineering, WRE, and natural resource management, NRM. You will find videos on various water topics such as hydrology, hydraulics, and watershed management, natural resource management and GIS, and many more related to water. The first video is only to share my career journey in water resource sector so that people watching this video would know what the career options are and where and how can they start their career journey in water resource sector. So I have been working in water resource sector for last 20 years, and which I feel is a unique and very diversified work experience. So basically, to get you an idea, let's divide this experience in three parts so it will help you to understand in a better way. The first one is development sector, or you can call it rural development. Second, consulting engineering. And the third one is information technology, that is IT. So let's start one by one. Under development sector, I worked at a grassroots level organization in NRM. Second, in consulting engineering, I worked for a multinational organization in urban water engineering management. And the third one is in information technology, that is IT sector. I have been working in hydraulics and hydrology softwares to provide water resource modeling solutions for worldwide clients, such as consulting organizations and municipal corporations and local bodies. So I gained diversified experience within the water sector itself. I would say there are plenty of areas for the career options to choose in the water sector alone. Some of you may find this video very helpful to plan their career in water resource sector, and some might have already started. Also, some of the students already pursuing water or environmental education in various institutions, colleges around the world. I personally love rivers, hills, valleys, countryside areas, and the things which is in context with nature conservation. I consider myself a blessed person because I had chosen water career since I passed out civil engineering, and since then no looking back, and journey continues. Water resource being a unique and scarce commodity due to rapid urbanization and industrialization and increasing agriculture use have contributed to worldwide water shortages. Very few people think about this career, and they never imagine water resource could be one of the career path along with other civil engineering subjects such as roadways, railways, bridges, etc. Though there are environmental water resource engineering subjects in civil engineering graduates and masters level, but very few can think of making career in it. You will be amazed by knowing how I started my career in water resource and where I am at present. So watch this video till the end so you would not miss any valuable information and motivate you to choose a career path in water resources, and eventually that could be a turning point of your life. So let's jump right into it. I have been serving water resource sector right from the grassroots level organizations to the national and international consulting organizations to the IT sector, as I mentioned earlier. So I will share with you one by one. So I started my career as an NRM trainee in a national level NGO in India. So this NRM was under the program known as cadre building for NRM, that is cadre building for natural resource management. It was sponsored by SDC, that is Swiss Development Corporation. It is an international funding agency. It offers funds for the developing countries to alleviate the poverty through the implementation of watershed development program and allied activities. For your information, all developed countries have a separate financial budget for this kind of activities for developing countries. Any non-government organization can receive funds under FCRA, that is Foreign Contribution Regulation Act, and can utilize this fund for the project which they have received the funds. Anyway, this can be a separate topic of discussion, and I will come up with detailed video on similar topics such as funding agencies, international cooperation, NGOs, and so on. So stay tuned. So let's discuss what I learned in this training. They have a very planned program of 1 year covering theory and practical modules in context with NRM and socio-technical point of view. So in theory modules, I learned how to formulate project proposals for international and national funding agencies, planning, designing of natural resource management projects for development sector in rural Maharashtra, the state of India. Also the topographical survey, micro planning or net planning, design, estimation and costing of soil and water conservation structures at various locations in rural Maharashtra. And after learning theory module, we had to go to field and apply theory part practically in the field. So this first experience was simply an amazing. So after completion of training period, I got an opportunity to work in a grassroots level NGO working in integrated watershed development program as well as foreign funded water supply and sanitation program. So I worked on both the projects. I worked there for 2 years and have been exposed with many things like work culture of NGOs, planning of the projects, interacting with the rural and tribal communities in rural Maharashtra, planning, design and implementing of the development projects. So after spending almost 3 years at grassroots level in an NGO, the new opportunity was already waiting for me. So I decided to jump into private water management consulting organizations where I gained work experience in planning and designing of urban water engineering projects for large municipal corporations and various governments and local bodies. I also learned few hydraulic engineering softwares. So this experience gave me in-depth knowledge of water resource engineering during my 5 years of tenure in this organization. At this time, I was already in the middle of the career, and at some point of time, life can take a sudden change, and that's the turning point in a career for anyone. Yes, and that turning point came into my life too. While working, I was exploring the higher studies options abroad. Luckily, I succeeded in it, and I got an admission in a world's largest water education facility in the Netherlands, known as IHE Delft. So I got admitted for Masters in Water Supply Engineering under the program of Municipal Water and Infrastructure. And for this, I have been awarded fully funded Netherlands Fellowship Program, NFP, for 2 years. Now it is known as OKP, that is Orange Knowledge Program. In this mid-career Masters program, I have been exposed to many things in global water resource sector. It was mesmerizing experience where more than 200 students came from every corner of the world and enrolled every year under various water courses. It was a great opportunity for me to networking with these masters and PhD students, also the professors, lecturers, water industry experts. There is a lot more to tell about this experience. So I will upload a detailed video on this water education topic very soon. After completion of this 2 year master's program, I joined an international consulting organization in India where I experienced micro level planning of urban and water engineering projects. I have been involved in planning and designing of many large and urban water supply and sanitation projects at international level. It gave me in-depth understanding of integrated urban water engineering. It was a very insightful experience. So now let's move on to my next experience. While working in previous organization, I did not think of switching my job very soon, but something happened and I got a chance to work for an IT industry in a hydraulics and hydrology softwares. The organization is having various software solutions to their portfolio related to water and storm sewer. It was a completely new experience for me and still I am enjoying it. So this was indeed a great experience so far. So I think the time to wrap the things up. So far, my career journey is very diversified and that too in water resource sector. Of course, there are many ups and downs throughout the journey and hence not possible to cover in this short video. Hope you did enjoy my diversified career journey in this video. I hope this will help you to decide your own career path in water resource and other related areas. But one thing is for sure that you can have multiple options in water resource as a career path, such as NGOs, private consulting organizations, funding or donor agencies like World Bank or FAO. I mentioned only few names, but there are a lot more. IT sector, or you can have your own organization and start doing business activities in areas which suits you in water sector. Yeah, why not? You can have your own water resource organization after gaining some years of experience in this field. At least I will have my own organization in water resource and GIS in future. So stay tuned for more videos, as this video was only to share my journey as a water resource engineer. But mainly we will focus on water education and awareness. My upcoming videos mostly will be on technical and knowledge sharing in hydraulics and hydrology and GIS. Please subscribe SIWRI channel, share the videos and hit like button, and comment below for any suggestions and ideas, and I will try to address it in my upcoming videos. So cheers, see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.